Lots of love. This is your host, saxophonist Will Donato. Welcome to Will Donato and Friends Show, where we are a forum for artists to showcase and talk about their new projects, mostly through their music. I want to thank each and every one of you for tuning into my show. You guys are such great company. We're having such a great time. I'm so grateful about your positive comments about the show. We begin our Will Donato and Friends show with my dear friend and esteemed label mate, prolific hit maker, guitarist Blake Aaron. I cannot say enough great things about his artistry. The LA Times described him as a genius on guitar and contemporary jazz sax, and flute great Najee aptly describes Blake as one of the greatest treasures as a guitarist. I love reading Blake's credits. Blake has, to his credits, 6 Billboard number one tunes, including the Radio Wave Song of the Year from 2019, Drive. I've actually got to play the song several times. It is stunning. His latest album, Color and Passion, created 3 number one Billboard hits. Blake, welcome to the show. Can you please give our audience a background on your accomplished career and also talk about your stunning brand new single, She's the One, which, by the way, is already burning up the charts.
Hey, it's guitarist Blake Aaron, and I'm excited to be here together with you on Smooth Jazz Live Radio 365. I want to thank you for listening and supporting new and live contemporary jazz music. You truly are the inspiration behind creating new music, and I want you to know that your support is not taken for granted. I started my career just after going to music school, and because I had a love for almost every genre of music, I did just about everything in my music career that you could possibly imagine. Playing in the studio and on the road with funk bands, R&B bands, rock bands, jazz bands, big name artists, small name artists, TV shows, movies, everyone from the Gap Band to Bobby Womack to Carlos Santana to Lakeside to Dynasty to being the guitarist on the TV show Mad TV for 15 years. I also had a love for teaching, and when one of my students, who was an Olympic gold medalist, heard one of my first EPs, he decided to invest in my career to help me go from being a sideman to being my own artist. And so my first full CD, With Every Touch, was born. 6 CDs and 5 number one Billboard hits later, I'm beyond excited to share with you my just-released and newest hopeful number one Billboard single, She's the One. You know, I can immediately tell when a groove which does not yet have a melody is going to be very special, when inspiration for composing an unforgettable melody comes within minutes of me hearing it. And as soon as I heard this beautiful groove from Adam Hawley and Carnell Harrell, it instantly inspired me to write a captivating and infectious guitar melody, which I sang into my iPhone, and the single She's the One was born. And in this day and age of musicians collaborating over the internet, this was actually the second time Adam and I decided to collaborate old school style, which means we met in the studio in person and we didn't leave until we actually had 2 hit songs. So you'll have to stay tuned for that second one released this summer, and I'll look forward to being right back here to share it with you then. But in the meantime, here's my brand new hit single, She's the One, on Smooth Jazz Live Radio 365.
Blake, I just love this song. Great work and congratulations on She's the One garnering number one position on the Smooth Jazz Network chart. Blake, your song Drive was one of three Billboard number one hits from your latest album, Color and Passion. It also garnered the coveted Radio Wave Song of the Year. I would love to hear your backstory on the creation of this tune.
Thanks, Will. Drive was the second project I did with the stellar saxophonist and producer Darren Rahn right after we had our number one with Groovers and Shakers. And I'll tell you that story in just a bit. But I needed a really strong show opener, a song that would segue seamlessly out of the intro that I do, which starts from the audience, and a song that would capture the audience right away and hook them into the rest of the show. So for radio, I wanted listeners to feel like this was their theme for their long drive home or a road trip on a summer night with the top down. So I went back to Darren and he came up with this really cool synth bass driven backing track. And once again, it immediately inspired the melody I wrote, which became the song Drive. Well, I guess more people than I thought adopted Drive as their cruising theme because my radio promoter, Adam Leibowitz, called me and told me that Drive became the number one song of the year on Radio Wave. So I hope Drive becomes your new cruising theme, and here it is on the Will Donato and Friends show on Smooth Jazz Live Radio 365.
Thank you.
Lots of love. This is your host, Will Donato, and I'm chatting with my buddy and esteemed label mate, Blake Aaron. And yet a number one hit from your album, Color and Passion, is Groovers and Shakers, featuring Saxman Darren Ron. Blake, can you please tell our audience about the creation of this song? I've had a chance to play this song live, and it's incredible. And it is such an impactful tune, and it's a crowd favorite.
Aw, thank you, Will. Groovers and Shakers was actually the first song Darren Ron and I did together. I had been trying to work together with Darren for a while, but our schedules never quite seemed to match up. And I saw him at the NAMM show in January, and we made a plan to work together, but it wasn't until July of that year that just as I was on my way out to spend the day at the beach with my family, that I was surprised with this really cool backing track in my email from Darren. And after waiting this long, I just had to listen to it before I got in the car. So musically, it had a lot of complex and really unique chord changes, harmonies, and modulations, but there was also a very hooky simplicity to it at the same time. I really knew it was special because I wrote the melody for the song in the first 5 minutes of hearing it. And as my family impatiently waited in the car yelling, "Come on, Dad," I quickly recorded my guitar on top of Darren's track, and that became Groovers and Shakers. Now, it seemed to work because we ended up going number one on Billboard, and now for the shows that we do together, I have the honor of playing that song with my friend Will Donato live. So here's Groovers and Shakers on my buddy the Will Donato and Friends show on Smooth Jazz Live Radio 365.
Blake, I can't thank you enough for coming on the show. Will Donato and friends, see you very soon on the road.
Thank you so much, Will. It's always an honor and a pleasure to hang out with you, and I'm looking forward to all of our shows together this year. Please join me at BlakeAaron.com. That's BlakeAaron.com for all of the latest news and tour dates, on Facebook at Blake Aaron Artist, on Instagram and Twitter at Blake Aaron Music, and Spotify and YouTube under Blake Aaron. Thanks again to my buddy here, Will Donato, and Jack Cohen, and to all of the supportive friends and fans. We always appreciate you and want you to know that we couldn't do it without you. I look forward to seeing all of you next time.
This is your musical host, Will Donato, and now our musical journey takes us to Florida, home of Billboard charting saxophonist and great guy, Chris Godper. Chris has a new gospel jazz EP out called Meant to Be, and the newly released title track is already burning up the airwaves. Chris has denied convention by excelling in the contemporary jazz genre as a saxophonist composer, despite being afflicted with asthma. Chris, welcome to the show. Can you please tell our audience about the creation of your new tune, Meant to Be?
Hey, this is saxophonist Chris Godber, and thank you so much for having me on the show. So my latest single is actually the title track to my new EP, and it's kind of my testimony in music. Being a professional saxophone player was never my plan growing up. I actually wanted to be a fighter pilot. My dad was Air Force, and I wanted to go military, all things. I watched too much Top Gun growing up, and I wanted to fly jets and be Maverick. Unfortunately, I have asthma, and they wouldn't take me. So I became a professional saxophone player instead, because that makes more sense. But no, really, my doctors growing up told me I couldn't play the saxophone either because of how bad my asthma was. And ultimately, I gave the saxophone over to God. In 1997, I started playing saxophone in sixth grade against doctors' advice. They thought my asthma was too bad and tried to talk me out of it. But that's what I really wanted to do. And I did that. And played, you know, all through high school. And then my senior year of high school, I started playing professionally, getting dinner gigs and weddings and things like that. And that became my full-time job. And I've been doing that ever since. I actually went to school to be a respiratory therapist, even though I've been full-time music for years. That is my part-time job and how I get health insurance. It also really came in handy during COVID when the whole world shut down, and thankfully I still had a job. So I'm a saxophonist and a therapist. I'm a sax therapist. That's not by accident, right? So that's the theme of this project, is that Romans 8:28 says that all things work together for the good of those who love him and are called according to his purpose. And that's what I believe sums this up. I'm exactly who and where I'm meant to be. So that's the name of this new song, this new project. I hope you guys like it. This is Meant to Be.
Lots of love. Will Donato here of Will Donato and Friends. Next up, we welcome renowned hit-making guitarist Lawson Rollins to the show. So excited to have you on the show, my friend. Lawson has 13 solo albums to his credit, including 2 number one Billboard contemporary charting songs, and his YouTube videos have garnered over 10 million views. Acoustic Guitar Magazine had this to say about Lawson. Lawson Rollins is a guitarist that is functioning at the highest level of his craft. He is a guitarist that has the chops to play almost anything, but seems to choose taste over everything. Lawson Rollins is a world-class player, composer, plain and simple. What a great quote. Lawson's new single, After Twilight, is already a Billboard hit and still rising. Lawson, can you please tell us about your new release?
Hi, this is guitarist Lawson Rollins, and it's great to be on the Will Donato and Friends show. I play the classical Spanish nylon string guitar, fingerstyle, and I've been making records for almost 25 years. I suppose you could call my music a blend of a whole multicultural array of different genres, everything from salsa to samba to bossa nova, Latin jazz, with a little bit of blues and R&B mixed in. And on my latest album, my 17th release, Infinite Chill Volume 2, you hear something a little different. It's a chill-out, electronica-influenced remixing, reimagining, and re-recording of 10 songs from my past albums. And it's kind of a sequel to a 2015 album I did entitled Infinite Chill, The Remix Sessions. And on this newest one, I brought in a whole array of new artists to bring new life to some of my older tracks, but I've also recorded a brand new one for you entitled After Twilight, which features my good friend Steven DeRose on the Rhodes electric piano, some fantastic bass playing from Dan Fisley from San Francisco, and a different approach from me on the guitar where I kind of lay back in the groove, don't try to assert myself quite as much as I often do, and just let the tune unfold naturally in a much more relaxed manner. So I hope you enjoy After Twilight on the Will Donato and Friends show. And once again, this is guitarist Lawson Rollins. And thanks for listening.
Next, our musical journey takes us to New Mexico, home of creative extraordinaire, trumpet composer, male model, Ryan Montano. Ryan is a 5-time Billboard charting recording artist known for his gorgeous tone on trumpet. His current record, Enchanted Lands, is getting radio play all across the United States, Europe, and his latest album, Truth Journey, has garnered over 4 million streams on Spotify. Ryan, an acclaimed filmmaker, has created a stunning music video for Enchanted Lands that we are featuring on our website at smoothjazzliveradio365.com. To view, click on the featured video tab on our menu bar. And now, take it away, Ryan.
Hello, I'm trumpeter Ryan Montano, and I'm really excited to share with you my new song, Enchanted Lands. The genesis of the song came from my friend, songwriter and film producer, Kenneth Segura Knoll. He had this song that he had played on piano for many years, and he sent me the recording and said, "You know what, Ryan? I would love for you to do your own creative interpretation of this song. No holds barred, no rules, just whatever you're hearing creatively, I'd love for you to record that on your trumpet." That original demo that he sent me sounded like this. There was a lot of directions that the song could have gone, especially with the creative freedom that was afforded with this project. I felt that a straight-ahead jazz slash Latin jazz sort of approach would fit the song really well. Using those rhythms as a foundation, I began to construct the song, and before too long, you can tell that this song had legs. So we went into the studio, and we contracted some of the finest musicians in Albuquerque and the state of New Mexico, and we began recording the song. And it was at that point that we realized that this song encompassed a creative spirit of New Mexico. The creators of the song were native New Mexicans. The musicians and engineers that helped craft the song are native New Mexicans. While we would record the song during the day, there were times when I needed a break, and it was usually at night. So at that point, I would take my camera, I would go out to different locations around the city of Albuquerque and the state, and shoot long exposure time-lapse photographs. It was a nice reprieve from the creative and sometimes arduous input of creating a song like Enchanted Lands. Those photographs and those time lapses ended up becoming the music video for Enchanted Lands. And it was through all these processes of creating music with New Mexicans, writing a song with a fellow native New Mexican, and then shooting the photography of different locations around the state that this song was encompassing a spirit of New Mexico. It was encompassing a spirit of brotherhood with people that share the energy and the creative spirit of this land. And so, ladies and gentlemen, I'm excited to share with you my new song, Enchanted Lands.
Lots of love. This is your host, Will Donato of Will Donato and Friends. Top of the genre icon, multi-instrumentalist, songwriter, and producer Brian Culbertson has 26 albums to his credit and 40 number one singles. That's just incredible. He has crafted another gem titled Sandcastles 2.0, which is already burning up the airwaves. Here's what Brian had to say about making music.
Man, it's... The thing is, it's to me, it's always been about staying true to what you feel is good music to you. Don't chase anyone else's ideas of what music should be. Play music, I said it earlier, from your heart, and it will be authentic. Be authentic. Mm-hmm. I hate it when I hear records that are clearly inauthentic. And what I mean by that is they're just following the trends, doing what they think will get on radio, you know? And it's like, that's not gonna stand the test of time, you know? If you do something that there's real feeling and real passion in it, I think people will respond more to it and you'll have some longevity to it. And also something that I remember Bud Harner, who got me my first deal, he always told me, Brian, it's about a compelling melody. If you can write a melody that can stick in people's heads, that's key. So really, really focus on the melodies. Make sure you can sing along and remember those. And you want those catchy hooks that people like will get mad at you late at night when they're trying to song won't get out of my head.
And now we bring you Sandcastles 2.0 right here on Will Donato and Friends. Let me take a quick sip of coffee here. Ah, pow! That was good. Lots of love. This is your host, Will Donato. National recording artist and saxophonist D. Lucas's career has spanned 20 years. D is a three-time Billboard charting smooth jazz artist with four number one hits across various smooth jazz charts. D's brand new album titled No Boundaries marks his 10th release to date. His current single, an incredible tune, Tighten Up, is burning up the smooth jazz charts already. D, my friend, welcome to the show. Can you please tell us the backstory behind the creation of this tune?
Hi, this is D Lucas, and thank you for having me on your show. My career goes back 20 years as a solo artist, but even before then is where I really started to put together all the pieces to get to where I am now. I'm self-taught. I did not pick up the saxophone until I was 28 after I graduated from college. But even before then, I've always had the love affair for music. I grew up in a household listening to a lot of different styles of music, whether it's R&B, soul, pop, gospel, blues, soft rock, you name it. I mean, every style of music on the radio stations. Growing up, I listened to it. But it wasn't until I graduated from college, moved to Atlanta, is where I wanted to pursue my interest in music. So I bought a saxophone and I started teaching myself, and I started to surround myself around talented musicians in the Atlanta area, and that kind of fed my hunger to pursue live performance. So I joined a band in the late 90s, did that for 2 or 3 years, and then it wasn't until 2004 that I wanted to strike on my own and become a solo artist and do the music that I wanted to do. And I started in 2004, and I think between every 2 to 3 years, I would put out a record. So here we are, 20 years later, I've released 10 albums. I've had the great fortunes to have great producers to help shape the music that I want to say artistically, like Adam Hawley, David P. Stevens, Darrell Williams, Lou Lang Jr., Phil Davis. Those guys brought a lot to the table, and then it gave me room to grow as an artist and also helped me say the things that I want to say on record. So this year, I have a brand new record coming out in September, and it's called 20, and it basically marks 20 years as a solo artist for myself. And I have a brand new single that I just released. It's called Tighten Up, which is going to be the lead single off the album. And Tighten Up is produced by Adam Hawley. And I hope that you enjoy it. Thank you.
I wanted to give a shout out to my colleague and talented friend, Peter Scott, host of the countdown of the Billboard Top 15. Peter, I've really enjoyed listening to your fun facts about the artists and your very entertaining Peter's Pick of the Week right here on Smooth Jazz Live Radio 365.com. Keep up the great work, buddy. I love your passion. Well, I miss you guys already. What a wonderful show. I wanted to thank you all so much for tuning in to my Will Donato and Friends radio show, broadcasting four times every day of the week. You can see the radio schedule by clicking on the schedule menu tab on our website at smoothjazzliveradio365.com. I hope you had as much fun listening as I had creating this broadcast. And now I conclude the show with my Billboard number one hit, Infinite Soul. Lots of love, everyone.